onside action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He makes it to the 25-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Tackled for a loss, so they wrapped him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option.
And drag the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Looking for the corner. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
And down he goes at the 46-yard line. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 46-yard line. Here's the halfback. And they make the stop around the 44-yard line. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Makes the grab past the marker, and he's taken down at the 26.
Well, we get a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
First and 10, ball on the 26. As the halfback took it in for the score.
Here's a play that was well designed and well executed. It can't get much better than that.
So they had their chances to stop him, but in the end, he comes up with a big play. And he adds the extra point. So a fourth play, 49-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 7-0. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. At the 30.
Kirk, you got to love the way this football game has started for this team. They put a lot of work into it. It's working for them.
Yeah, they've been able to capture the momentum of this game early. It's such a pivotal part of winning a college football game is holding on to that now. Let's just see if they're able to maintain it.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
yardage situation here. Second down and one. He's taken down at the 45. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
To maybe the 43-yard line.
Gaining 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From the 43-yard line, second down. And he's tackled around the 33-yard line. And so the fullback gets a nice gain on the option there. They're using everyone.
Well, the thing about the option as a defense, you have to account for everybody. Here, the offense gives it to the fullback, and he picks up the first down on a huge gain.
They'll drop it for a loss. From the 35-yard line, second down. Brought down at the 37.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. Blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That makes it first and 10.
Try him again, and this time they've got him in the backfield.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. He guns it to the left. Makes the catch, and look out. Tackle at the 48.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
From the 48-yard line, first down. Hang on, everybody, because it looks like they came ready to play today. 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Down, 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 down.
to the tailback. They'll bring him down at the 31. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. He tackles him for a loss. So the halfback loses about two on the run. Here's the eighth play of the series. Down and they need to get it to the 21. They come out in a five wide set. Gets it out in a hurry. Makes the grab and steps out right away. Tenth play of the drive. His second touchdown of the day.
This young man is no stranger to the end zone. That's two rushing scores for him on the day, and you have to love the way he's been running the ball all game.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's taken down at the 23. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. On the pitch, look out, loose ball. The defense has it. So it's the cornerback that comes up with a fumble, and this ball will change hands.
Fumbles will absolutely drown an offense. It's hard to get into a rhythm when you make mistakes like that.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Touchdown! Triple dip, folks.
Hey, these guys are coming out firing on all cylinders. They've really taken control of this game early.
And he hits the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Gets out to about the 32-yard line.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a zero up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. He's to the 40. Excellent open field tackle.
Sometimes when you've got speed, that's all you need. It's the one thing you just can't defend.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. He's tackled at the 47.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. To about the 31-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
He fights forward to about the 30. Second and nine. Ball on the 30. And they get nice yardage on that run. Comes the pressure. And down he goes around the 10-yard line.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
First and 10. 10 yards to the end zone. Get him in the backfield. Georgia Tech will take their first time out of the half. This is the eighth play of this drive.
He wasn't decisive at all on that option. And once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
They bring him down in the backfield.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. He shoved out of bounds at the 4. The kick is up, and it is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Across the 30. They'll bring him down at the 34. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. He's tackled in the open field, so it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and they make the stop right around the 42-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Makes it out to about the 46. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
The catch and gets out of bounds.
Hey.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Grabs it and hammered right there. Gets it out to the line out, and he's got the first, and he's taken down at about the 19-yard line. He flings it. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. The extra point. An 8-play, 66-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. I'm really surprised how lopsided this first half has been. But this is college football, and no matter what the score is, the adrenaline's always pumping on both sides. He tries to buy some time. Slides down to the ground. That scramble gets them 7 yards. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made at the 45-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 33. Under heavy pressure, going deep. He's picked it off. This time it's the safety.
Can these guys do anything right? I mean, they're already getting blown out, and now another interception? This is just one of those days.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 22. He's out to the 30. Makes it to the 31. One half remains, but it looks like we might have a major upset brewing. 28-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
I'd like to put this more delicately if I could, but if this were a horse, they would put it out of its misery. This game is ugly and completely non-competitive.
No, one of these teams is not like the other. I mean, one's really good and one's not. And I don't know how to sugarcoat it anymore. Maybe we could say that the second half will be better. But what you've seen so far, you're probably going to get a lot more because I don't see any advantages or anything to take advantage of. One team's just superior in talent, superior in coaching, superior really in every single facet of the ballgame.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something to the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
Welcome back to the action, and we hope the action will even up a little bit here in quarter number 3. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 26. So they're just about set to get the game going again. He's got an opening.
his tackle at the 39. So we've got a first down after a great running play. And the halfback picks up 9 yards on the delay.
Call it a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
There's a play fake. He's under pressure. He's taken down at about the 13. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 13. Stopped in his tracks with that tackle.
Number 32 makes the tackle at the 10-yard line. That'll make it second and seven.
He scrambled. Brought down at about the 9-yard line. It's third and six coming up. Ball on the 9. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Scrambling around. Tackle around the 9-yard line. Kicks away, and he got it. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. And he's hit immediately.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want it.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Caught out of the open. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line.
Pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He's on the run. He's tackled around the 39-yard line. So the scramble goes for 9 yards.
That'll bring up third and inches.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Nice run there.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
And down he goes at the 28-yard line.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's going to try and scramble. Runs with it, and he's got room. And they make the stop at the 19-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. And goal from the four. They're knocking on the door. And he's taken down around the 2 yard line. The option keeper gets him two, maybe 3 yards. 10th play of the drive. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line deep. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Really good play here in run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
Here we go, third and goal from the 3 yard line. Tackle made at the three, and he gets a yard on the run. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. Georgia Tech is ready to kick it away. He'll return it from the three. The Yellow Jackets have simply rocked the college football world with an astounding effort in this one.
This is one of the biggest upsets I think we've seen all year. You know what's great? They didn't worry about any of the outside distractions. They just kind of locked in to themselves and their coaches, getting ready for this football game, and it's really paid off for them.
Gets out to around the 38. Can you believe it? We head to the fourth quarter in what has been a stunning game. 31-6. Just about set to start the fourth quarter, mercifully. He's at midfield, and he is drilled at the 46. That makes it first and 10. From the 46-yard line, first down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he hits him hard at the 38-yard line.
Number 15 makes the tackle at the 38-yard line. That makes it second and two.
Play action. Throws to the tight end, and that falls incomplete. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He makes it to the 38-yard line. It out left, got the fullback, and he's tackled at the 37. The defense holds, and the ball will change hands. And And it'll be interesting to see how much fight this team has left in them. This has been a brutal game. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. He's scrambling, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's taken down around the 42-yard line.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
And he's shoved out of bounds at the 23-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Clipping. Receiving team.
So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. They'll line up at the 11. It's first down. And off, and he's met immediately. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Makes it out to about the 20. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Yardage on that run. From their own 24-yard line, first down. Up the middle for a nice game. He makes his way to about the 42. Well, some backups got some playing time today, that's for sure. It's final, 31-6. So that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.